Dang, and I thought I knew that was noisy. Oh man. What a noise. Jesus. What a noise. So, Yamaha XT660R with double Leo Vinci exhaust, which by the way sound noisy. I think that's the only description you can give it. Obviously it's simplicity is beauty in this case. And like any test ride bike, there are some things you would like to change, including mirrors, for example. So the dashboard is all very, very clear. Let's put it in neutral. Neutral light also very, very clear. It doesn't have a gear indicator. It does have an engine light. It does have a gasoline light. It does have a neutral light indicators, of course. A fuel light. It shows the kilometers. It shows the kilometers driven on this trip. Total kilometers on the engine. It shows the time. I've ridden this beast for a little bit now. I'm gonna return it. And before I'm gonna return it, I'm gonna enjoy it a little bit more and talk to you guys about it. And those are Scooter Boys with the same type ID I have. And Scooter Boys that wave at the motorcycle. Ooh. High seating position, quite a straight back, a very comfortable saddle for so far. Mirrors give me plenty of view, I can easily access all the buttons. Very nice rear suspension, a little bit stiff front suspension, but that might, you know, might be just a quick fix or just the way it is or the way I ride it. It leans well. I have the feeling it leans better than the Honda. This is the closest comparison I have, because in the oldie days they were literally each other's competitors. I like the blue look. Okay. Suspension check, all right. I mean the noise, all the noise. It's more noisy than the bloody Nuda. Although the Nuda had more beautiful noise. And this is more noise. No early rise on a Sunday morning like 9 o'clock, because you will wake the shit out of everybody. So yeah, after about, let's say, 30 minutes riding, what's the biggest downside? Either the fact that it struggles really hard in the low RPMs, so you do have to gear shift. You do have to shift gears quite a lot in the lower shifters. it's a little bit too hooliganish. You can feel it. You want to drive faster than is legally allowed, and you do have that feeling with a lot of bikes, but you also want to do overtakes where it's not really safe or legal, or maybe not even possible for other bikes. It gets that hooliganish feeling. Now that's not a bad thing. And if you can really, this one could probably really very easily. I can't really, so I'm not gonna try. I mean, better safe than sorry for me. Okay, one quick horn test. Wait until the fishes are gone. Not much. That's way more obviously and visually hearable. I'm quickly gonna push it across the highway to see how it does there. Although I do have a beautiful idea. Still in the case that I need some gasoline, so I might fill her up a little bit. So it can do and it will do highway speeds. It doesn't feel like it's exploding beneath your balls, whatever. It's not like you're overforcing it, which is good. Obviously, I'm not going to take it 20 minutes over the highway, but the short amount, it feels good on the highway. I really like the stability it has and the amount of torque it still can deliver when you need it. Now I'm gonna take this exit so I can fill her up with the gas a little bit, because she's definitely low. And companies like it when you give their bike back with fresh gas. So let's do that. And after that, one more shot, and then she's going home. This blue miracle XT660R. I like the plops when it's backfiring. Engine turns off when you put the standard out. Good to know. Off, out, open, turn, and it comes out fully. Only fits one way. Let's start her up. Ooh, fresh gasoline, that's better. Sometimes you can just feel it. Ooh, it sticks to the road. Real nice. Brakes even better. There's a powerful rear brake, really powerful rear brake. will put specifications on screen on of this specific model and of the latest model they have. Obviously, I'm not testing the latest model, I'm testing this model. But it gives you an idea if you want to be if you want to buy the newest model, how it would quickly testing how it feels off-road. Because this is a bigger machine. Feels like it can handle itself quite well. It is slipping and sliding a bit, but it is finding its way. And it's doing what it needs to be done. Curb jump. Whee! That's the Yamaha XT660R. It's a beautiful machine. For the people that like this type of machine. I want to give a special thank you to Motorstore Barendrecht for lending this machine. And with that being said, I want to say thank you for watching. Hopefully till very soon. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. And comment if you want to see a different type of motorcycle. Thank you, Mr. Barendrecht.